Envizi became part of IBM in 2022. Can you share with us a little bit about your journey with Envizi and the motivations, I guess, for taking it to the next level and becoming part of IBM?
For me personally, the Envizi inspiration came back in around 2007. Al Gore and Inconvenient Truth. Michaela's probably too young to remember that. But, you know, that was a moment for me where after about 15 years of tech entrepreneurship, I really felt I love technology, but I was looking for something that was a little bit more rewarding than technology for technology's sake. And, you know, this whole notion of climate change and the existential threat we were facing from global warming was something that really resonated with me. And I remember walking out of the Al Gore Inconvenient Truth movie, and I turned to my wife in the Westfield Bondi Junction car park and I said, I think I'm going to do a startup in the climate change space, and we're going to go and build some carbon software. And that's literally where it started for me. You know, if you look at where Envizi was in sort of October, November 2021, when we started to talk to IBM, we actually weren't looking to sell the business. We were actually at the tail end of a capital raising process. We were out to raise $80 million in capital to take the business global. We'd built a fantastic team of about 70 people here in Australia. We had incredible customers, you know, all the big retailers, the banks, the major property firms. We had some amazing global customers like IBM and Microsoft, Cisco. But we'd always been held back by the market and not really having that groundswell of global momentum around sustainability and climate change. And interestingly enough, during the pandemic, it's probably the last time, it's the most unlikely time that you would expect a business to suddenly go through this incredible
yes.
growth phase. And it's almost embarrassing. I think we grew 230% over the 2 years of the pandemic when so many other businesses struggled. But it was really a function around this inflection point in the market and the world really getting on board with sustainability. And it was at that point that we realized we really needed to grow. And we had these world-class clients, this world-class technology platform, but it really troubled me as to how we would scale. Now, obviously money was part of, you know, being able to scale, hence the desire to go out and raise $80 million. But you know, money alone doesn't necessarily guarantee you success. And it was quite fortuitous that IBM were a client of ours. And we were in the final weeks of actually finalizing this capital raising, and I got a call from a gentleman by the name of Dr. Kareem Youssef, who's a long-term IBMer. He's now my boss. It took me a long time to say I hadn't had a boss for over 25 years. But Kareem really inspired me with the vision of, you know, how we could scale Envizi with inside of IBM and how we could ultimately, you know, bring together a number of IBM's existing products around facility and asset management, around supply chain optimization, around optimization of data center and cloud. And Envizi played such a critical role around the data and the reporting piece. And that was my sort of aha moment, which is really, I think we can be far more impactful inside of IBM than what we can if we take on funding and move ahead by ourselves. Yeah, it was obviously hard at an entrepreneur level to sort of let go of your baby, but yeah. I think it was, I'm absolutely convinced we made the right decision. Yeah, sometimes there is the right path to continue blazing your own trail, but sometimes you've got to look at the leverage and you know, we doubled our sales last year. We're looking to grow 300-400% again this year, and those are the kind of things that are quite hard to do independently. So IBM was absolutely the right place for Envizi to land, and I think it's going to give us that global leverage and that impact which I was looking for from the business, both from a commercial and business perspective, but more importantly the impact that we could have with our technology around helping corporates to decarbonize and tackle climate change.